Salanta Rastafari. This is Wendell Malanzo, and we just feel the need to have to share some very interesting information that we have been able to, that we have been given and been able to receive. Now, it all has to do with time and the whole 2012, but more correctly, it has to do with Rastafari Senbet Tenat, or Rastafari Senbet Study Number 4. And even more precisely, Shechem. Now, okay, just keep in mind, Shechem is kind of like carrying your cross. It's waking up in the morning and dealing with that which you have to deal with. It's carrying your burden on your back, and therefore it has to do with your lower neck and just above the wings of your back, your shoulder blades, and then it also has to do with speaking more metaphysically or psychologically, it has to do with getting over those things that have passed and moving forward. It also has to do with the oak tree and even with an oath. But let us just get right into this. Okay, so 2012, regardless of the accuracy of that date, and overlooking all that which has been said, the fact of the matter is that it is significant, because even if nothing happens, it gives us us Rastafari already know, because this change was introduced in His Imperial Majesty Kedamawi Haile Selassie since the dawning of this new era, as His Majesty said. His coronation was 1930, November 2nd, and so for the Rastafari, this change is kind of old news, but it's new in our hearts every day, right? But it's something that we've been well aware of for a long time now. But the latecomers, they've sought to keep their attention on 2012, and that's not all that strange, but we're not going to get into that. Need to say that even though, regardless, if anything happens, nothing happens, it has sparked change, or the idea of something about to happen. And so we're used to just having a linear time in where nothing happens. As a matter of fact, all that happens is, when are you going to pay your bills? When are you going to buy birthday presents? When are you going to buy candy for whatever event? If it's Easter, then you're going to buy little bunnies and put them in eggs, hide them somewhere. If it's Halloween, you're going to buy just random candy and just hand it out for no reason. You're going to buy costumes. You're going to get, if you have to go out on every Satan's Day on Saturday, it's new shoes, it's whatever. And I mean, just think of the logic. I mean, you're going out to a club, you're going to get stepped on, you're going to smell like smoke, you're going to get dirty, you're going to get beer spilled on you. If everything goes as planned, you're going to be so wasted that you might even end up vomiting yourself. And if the situation, as the world system makes it out to be, if it gets really good, then hopefully you never made it home, and you probably end up, in the side of a trash can, dead or kind of dead or something, and that's a good time in this world system. But whatever the case may be, it has triggered the idea of something's going to happen. It could very well be that society is so messed up because it's been implanted in the brains of the individuals that this whole end of the world, it's like, Geta Jesus Christos, I and I, God and Father, Kedamawi, Christ in His, Kedamawi Haile Selassie, Christ in His kingly character, turns out to be Ethiopian. And so, all this Protestant Reformation and all these Christian movements and the whole 1800s predicting the coming of Christ in His kingly character, and that whole vibe of He's coming, turns out He's an Ethiopian. it's the end of the world, everything's gonna fall apart, nothing, you know, you see, we could witness that change in mentality. 1800s was all about the coming of Christ. Christ came, Lich Tefere, that child was born in Ethiopia. Then, you know, they kind of, you know, these educated individuals started kind of like, well, you know, the end of the world is coming, like, you know, it's obvious for whatever reason they did not want to accept the truth. And so now it's like, okay, so cancel Christ's coming. You know, he's here, but turns out that we're not going to agree with the reality of the matter, because it might spark some kind of like feel some guilt. We might feel guilty for what we have done, you know? And so, I mean, let's not get all into that, but it's the end of the world. So now people have been born into a society where, you know, do whatever you want, you know, everything's going to hell because Christ and his kingly character happens to be Ethiopian, and we are not going to conform to that. So, I mean, just go all out and do what you want to do, and, you know, it's lights out from now. You know, darkness, these people are afraid of darkness. But, you know, we have a light that shineth very bright within the darkness. So the dark day of the Lord, of Geta Jesus Christus and his Father, our Father, Kedamawi Kali Shalasi, was a very dark day for these individuals and to this very day. But it needs not to be that way. You know, it's true and sincere repentance. So back to the whole our discussion. Actually, we didn't even have anything in mind, but we are going to present a very relevant information. Now, okay, so the whole idea of change, something's going to happen, you know, at least that has been presented. And that also gives us a different perspective. Now, it allows us to accept time as cycles. Every so often, stuff happens, you know. It's not only pay your bills, go to work, pay, and buy, and then, you know, consider that this kind of time is a merchant, is a Vatican merchant, pirates, you know, system to where they know when they're going to get paid, they know when to increase the prices, they know when everyone's kind of broke, you know, and so basically, 2012, at least, for and this is for the secular world, because Ras Tefere, I mean, we've been ushering in this change since the visitation of I and I, God and Father, you know, fully filling that section of scripture and everything pertaining to it. So now we can see a pattern of cycles. You know, time isn't necessarily just eternally, I guess, eternal damnation. Rather, it's a cycle of stuff, change, you know. And with that, it sparked within our minds. And this is because we heard that the Mayans have different kinds of cycles, but one of them is a 20. Every 20 years, they count 20 years. And so eventually it cuts off in 400 years. And so now it got us thinking. And then, you know, quickly, sure enough, 20, it's like, it called to mind the whole, and how they mention doves in scripture. We kind of forgot right now. It has to do with, scores, how they keep scores. And so that kind of like, so the whole four and twos, that's an eight right there, and so it quickly just started making sense, everything. But then we realized that the only difference was that, you know, they kind of messed, well, I'm not sure if they messed up, but they might have other cycles that agree with what we're going to present, but this four didn't seem right, and so we thought three. And it all made sense now, because it I mean, not that doesn't mean anything, right? Nothing happened, but it allowed us to go forth and kind of testified to a perfect witness, to sevens and threes, to three witnesses of seven. And we're gonna actually go to that, present on that, on I guess like in another presentation, forgive me. And so, okay, this already started like, you know, all kinds of stuff started popping up in Einstein's minds. And so, you know, 3 times 7 is 21, and 21, 21, 21, 21, well, it's, we're thinking it's, it's 84 maybe. But what we're trying to say is this, that the whole cycles, you know, the cycle divided in 4, and each quarter divided by 3 instead of divided by 4, as the Mayans did, right? And so we understood that we were in this area, the rising of the sun, we're entering growth and the quickening of the spirit, you know, passing over. This is what we had in mind, and it started making sense, because if we thought, okay, seven doesn't necessarily have to be just seven, you know, it could be three scores of a certain seven. So okay, you add a zero and that's 70, that kind of makes sense with scripture, the whole 72s and stuff like that. And then I added another zero, and that multiplies to 2100. I know that's not the 2012 and stuff like that. I mean, we're not trying to get the exactitude, because we are not taking in consideration this event right here. This, in fact, okay, this is the Earth, and it's tilted 23.5 degrees, and that's why it's kind of slanted. But what we're trying to do here is that, let's say this is North Pole, South Pole. The wobble of the Earth is kind of wobbling, so it wobbles into creating this cycle right here, this circle, and this one up here. And so what that does, it kind of messes up the whole being exact about it. And so that's why I don't worry about this not being exactly 2012. I mean, there's a lot of different things that come into play that honestly we have no idea how. But I mean, just keep in mind the 10% of the Almighty. This is precession. We don't even know how to spell it. Forgive me. Okay, this is precession, and this causes everything to move out of place. For instance, like, we have a set of stars, let's say the line of Judah. So we have the line of Judah, but because this is moving, people here, ancient civilizations upon Earth, cannot reference the stars or to keep accurate time, because it's wobbling, it's moving. So the next year, the very same day, the stars are not going to be in the same location. Therefore, time, so-called, is relevant to the position of the sun. And so that is why the equinoxes are so very important. But basically, we introduce the precession, the whole idea of precession, because we don't want people to get the idea that we're trying to you know, to get this exact and to come up with precise numbers. Who cares about that, honestly, at this point? We know who God is. We know what we are supposed to do. We're just trying to give ones an opportunity to, I don't know, I mean, hopefully learn something. But so we're not going to get to preciseness. The fact of the matter is that everyone is open now. Well, mostly everyone has been open to change. And let we just say that if you are not sincerely tired of your job, if you're not sick of the life you're living, and you don't have to be miserable. You could have children and have a nice home, whatever, and have a car with rims, whatever. You could be living the so-called life, right? But even then, if you honestly are tired, bored, just fed up with your life, then there's a chance within you, because you are entering this change, that you've conformed to this so-called system, and still it's not cutting it out for you. You know, you're it's not working out. And so that's good news. You know, that is good news. You are a part of this. If you are super into this world and you wouldn't want anything to change it, you are in a path of eternal damnation. We pray for you to change, because we cannot imagine ways of explaining something so dreadful that we, you know, we just cannot even picture where you're headed. So, you know, just, but, you know, probably those people will never consider even using YouTube or anything like that for anything beneficial. So who cares? Now back to the whole time. Now seven is an oath, and it's in Genesis. You know, we're not gonna go into detail because we kind of forgot. Our notes aren't here, and we didn't even set up for that. So this is our time. Now, I know everything sounds confusing, but Ja willing, it'll make sense in your minds, all right? We think differently, so we're not necessarily making the point that it appears that we were intending to make. We don't know what point we're trying to make. We're presenting information, and we hope it makes sense to some people. Now, okay, so we spoke of these being cut up into three instead of four. We know that 8 would actually make more sense, right? Because 8 would be, I guess, my bad. 8 times 3 would be 24. And so we would have a quarter, another quarter, another quarter, another quarter. That would be more closely tied to the 100%. That is a cycle, to the 360. But we're not convinced that a cycle has to be 360 degrees. See, that is where a lot of our miseducation in this whole uneducational system, that's where it comes into effect. We might just have to throw away everything we've learned, and I'm not saying that's the case, but you know, for our presentation's sake, that will be the case. So who cares about 360? I mean, who wrote that down? But we're not talking about 360 right now. We're talking about whatever it is that this happens to be. So regardless, I mean, 8 times 3 would be 24, but 7 times 3 would be 21. And we're trying to... We actually forgot where we were going with this. But we'll kind of go on forward where mobility is possible. We've always accepted that this, the depression, and that's where Shechem comes to play. This is forgotten right here. We had this idea, we had no idea how to present it, but we knew that this was forgotten. Time is not the time that they give us. We knew this was forgotten. So you take that from I guess 21, you get 14, no, forgive we. We kind of lost the idea. And forgive us for that, but 7714. It's something to the effect that the Ethiopian calendar has almost 8,000 years. All right, and so what we're trying to say is, man, we actually forgot what we were trying to say.